Hello everyone and welcome to It's Spring Clean Part 4. Lovely. My delivery for the washing detergent arrived today. I got 6 months worth of washing stuff off the Hoover, so yeah, looking lovely. I have some going to one of my aunts, which is really nice. But yeah, so I've got some darks and just everyday stuff to wash to start off. Enough. Don't know whether they've changed it or not again. Can't tell. So it's about 35 there, I think. Yeah. So, because of the way that the load sensing is, I'm going to stick it into the middle. We've got some soiled clothes. So we have, it's about a 5 kilo load, I think. Yeah, roughly around about 5. That's all I'm okay, hopefully. And then very softener. I'll stick it in rose oil, so so it is. Thank you.
Thank you.
The chrome door is halfway, isn't it? Tell you what, it's done a good job. Those were covered in rusty and so they were. Seems to have got them all right. Which I did expect, to be honest. So we're with the dryer, and that's stickies on the cottons, cover dry plus, and the mattress topper and the pillow all got done, so they did last night on duvet extra dry. I didn't actually have to stick it back on, so it didn't clean my dry first time, which was really nice. The two other pillows that were in took forever. I mean forever, but they got dried in the end. They just take a long time, so they do. They smell really, they smell really nice. I love the smell of fairy, but I don't know what this is going to be like with my skin. To be honest, my skin's broke out quite badly anyway, so we'll just see what happens. It just goes like that, so it does. It's not fun. Not fun living with eczema. I'm sorry if I'm talking quite quietly. My dad's asleep. And works fun hours. But yeah, so that's us all in. Water is all emptied out of that. So, like I said, cotton's covered dry plus. Let's go. Her thing's never off. Right, so we're on to our next wash now. It's even though it's getting quite late, so it is, it's 7 o'clock now. But we've got some dresses to wash, and these need freshened up, so they do. As they don't smell the nicest. They are new, so they are. But they've been stored for quite a bit. Elsewhere, not here. And they've need freshened up, so three dresses in nice. I think we will use our fairy combo again. Plenty of detergent there. And about 30 ml. So that's heading fine. Then some softener. That's a detergent all in. Time to wash her on. Going to use the machine's delicate cycle, I think, which is soft care. The real thing's the spin speed for me, to be honest. It's very, very slow spin. Hi, everyone. Lovely reflective thing, black fascia. So soft care is just machine's delicate wash, so it is. But it's quite interesting that you can sweat night and day on that. I wish it allowed a faster spin. I might have to re-spin them. Probably will have to re-spin them, to be honest. I don't really like that. It's a bit too slow. But 3400 RPM. It's doing quite a deep level main wash and to go action. So far it seems like a really good delicate wash. It's been a while since I've used one of those. It's reminded me of my Beko WM5100W's one a bit, so it is with a to go action. I'm so used to a darker wash, it uses a lot of water and fast wash action, a wee bit. Although I don't think Lamela does that. I can't really remember, to be honest. It's been a wee while since I used delicate on it, because I normally just stick extra gentle on too. But yeah, it seems to be doing a nice job. It's heating the water up to 39, so it is. Couldn't decide between this and active wash. I want to try active wash at some point, so I do. I think it seems to be a 20 minute quick wash for small loads. It seems nearly like it's an eco-friendly one or something. So I wonder if it's different from the rapid cycle. The rapid care typically uses quite a lot of water, to be honest. See the condensation on the door now. But even with that water level and that load being light, it is turning them over quite a bit, so it is. Like, they're not folding all the time, so they're not. They are moving about, which is nice. Oh, here and there. Was doing its temp holding, but I think it's at the end of the main wash now. It has reached temp, thankfully, so it has. Although the door isn't really that hot, with the fact the water isn't really really touching it. But to be honest, maybe it is a 30 and I just can't tell. I, never use 30. 40's normally my lowest that I'd go. The only other 30 cycle I've used on this is rapid. And then the rest have been 40, 60, and 90. I love my hot washes. So I do. Don't like colder stuff. can't see it doing in term spoons or anything like that, so I can't. It'll probably just drain and go on the rinses. If my assumptions are correct, it will drain at 34. Maybe they're not correct. It seemed to start to get another phase once I started filming. So we've just finished draining after main wash, and it seems like it's going to do an in-term spin, maybe. day. Well, it's not every day that you see a machine do an interim spins on its dock, its wash. This is it doing its main spin now, so it is. So it's doing its first rinse. I need to rescue the clothes from the dryer, so I do. It's giving off at me, beeping, beeping, beeping. it's just ever so slightly deeper than the main wash. It goes down, so rinse action is all it is. Seems to be doing a decent job. Imagine it's only got two rinses, I reckon. Which isn't bad at all, like. missed the final rinse with me, you know, sorting the dryer out. But we're on the final spin now. As expected, especially the likes of this dress here. The water's nearly dripping off that. So it is, it's just not enough of a spin, so it's not, I think I should really allow it to do, 800 RPM at least. On a delicate wash, I got parked there, soaking, so it is, yeah, very, very wet. But other than that, it was a really good delicate wash, and I really liked that. So I did, apart, just a shame that it only allows 400 RPM. So, spin and drain it is. I don't want to fill 1600, of course, so, I don't know why on earth you can select silent on it. Really weird. Drain and spin, 1000 RPM, 8 minutes. Let's go. Charging, hence why I'm not over closer to it. I think that's it at 1000 RPM now. I So this go to go in the dryer on Gentle Care Cupboard Dry Plus. Just with my phone filming, I won't film loading up the dryer, so I'll just go on that so it will. I want the phone to have charge for the towel wash that I'm going to do next. Right, so we're on to our final wash of today. So, got 3 loads done in total. This is a very, very heavily soiled towel wash that needs done. So we will put that on Cotton's 90 with a pre-wash. Just because of how dirty it is. It's really bad, really bad. There's some towels that have blood on them. There's other towels that have been used to wipe up the floor whenever the plumber was here. And some microfiber cloths and stuff like that that are in here that have been used for that purpose too. So I don't know if this will be a full load exactly. I think one of these towels was used to soak up orange juice. Don't know if it was that one or not, but that one is quite rank. It was kind of a disaster moment. So it was, and you can see like bits and all falling off these towels because of how dirty they are. I will need to hoover down here, so so we'll stick this onto a nice boil wash, so we will. As you can see, like, dirt and stuff there. It's absolute rank. Oh, yeah, this definitely all needs a pre-wash, without a doubt. Like you can see, all the crap that's fell off them. Bad, very dirty. Then finally I have a tea towel to stick in. So that's us all loaded up nicely. I'm absolutely going to need to hoover down here, so I am. We're going to use some aerial washing powder and maybe some fabric softener. Don't know what to do with softener wise. I think I'll just use that Lenore, to be honest. I've been using Fairy all day. As you can see with the way that the drawer pulls out, It's very, very awkward. Putting washing powder into the pre-wash compartment. So for that reason, I'm going to have to turn the camera off, to be honest. So I'll be back once the detergent's all loaded up. Okay, so that's our detergent all poured in. I've got about 60, 70 mil. I think more towards 70 mil in the pre-wash, and then round about 130 in the main wash. I'll stick my softener in after, so I will. So, turn it on. Cotton's 90, pre-wash. It says 4 hours now, but it won't actually take that long. And what time is it now? It's 8:30. It's taking us up to about 12. I think I'll do medium soil, to be honest. Stuff, how much of a rush I'm in. Hang on. It's 11:30. I'll just do medium soil. I just don't want it to be on half the night. It'll take off about an hour, I think. Sam. So that's a taken and it's pre-washed detergent now. Thankfully the detergent doesn't flow out of the jets, so it doesn't out of the wee nozzle, so really nice way that they designed it. It'll be pouring out there, I reckon, the washing stuff. Yeah, it's poured out and in, so it has. So I'll let it do its thing and I'll get all of this mess all cleaned up. Got everything cleaned up, thankfully, so I did. So it's on to it, it's doing its pre-wash, so it is. This does heat on its pre-wash, which is really nice. I think it's supposed to be around about 30 that it goes to, but the pre-wash is quite short on it, so it is. Although at the same time, the only time that I used pre-wash, the last time I used it, I had the low water pressure and it obviously took ages to fill up. So that, especially with the fact that on the pre-wash it tumbles one way and does pulse filling. So it does the same as what all-in-one does, and also if it needs a top-up on rinses. But it is rather short. It's the glass is still cold, so it is, but yeah, it's all it really needs, so it just needs, you know, I suppose like a quick rinse. It does a full length in term spin after the pre-wash, so it does, and then goes on the main wash. It's quite interesting, like it does like a full length 1000 RPM spin. It's crazy. So it is. But yeah, like, the glass hasn't started heating up yet, so it hasn't. I think it's only been, well, it's been washing for about maybe 10 minutes. You know, after filling up. After doing its saturation. Heater's quite a low wattage, so it takes it longer to heat up too, so it does. But yeah, it's nice, like it does a full length in term spin. Not Frotzy seeing it take a spin not unbalanced before. Just wants the job done. Overspared a wee bit because of how unbalanced it is. honestly surprised it's going for the full spin with this. This was the next spin attempt after I stopped filming. So it hasn't really spun long at all on balancing before just going for it. I'd probably only do this in terms of spinning around 800 just because of how unbalanced it is. Really shows how unbalanced it actually is, to be honest. I think it done 1,000. I think it normally does 1,000 too. Maybe prewash spins ever since it was lower. I think it done a 1,000 last time. Still really good in terms of spinning on the glass. Pre-wash guides went away and that's us on to main wash. I can't even remember, it might have went away earlier and I didn't even notice. Washing powder pouring in. Still need to do like top ups and stuff, so take it all in and any that doesn't all flush into it. So it's been washing for a wee bit now. I'm videoing. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's fine. Yes?
See, after the phone starts, you put my clothes on, will it?
Your what?
Yeah.
Yeah. If I love you that much.
Yeah.
Good riddance. I know. I so feel. I got all the washing powder rinsed out, so I did. Into the machine. Pretty much as soon as it's full up. Just stick on the floor.
Yeah.
So, got some manure there. Oh, sorry. Oh, sorry, David, that's Dennon. Oh, I hate my laugh on video. Oh, as long as it's not bad as that. That stupid one on that Becco Dangerously Unbalanced Spoon video. Oh, I hate that laugh. I hate watching that back. Oh, sick. Suppose I may stick him in the bin, man. Sick. Oh, sick. But yeah, it's pretty much almost at temp. I can't keep my hand on the glass because of how hot it is. So it will reach temp, definitely. 82 this one does on its power wash, which is really good for a modern machine. Hasn't got too sooty either, which is really nice. Wonder what the spins will be like. I wish I could use pre-wash and extra rinse together, but it doesn't let you change anything once the cycle started, so it doesn't. You can't change anything at all, so you can't. It's pretty much like the Mega. But if you press any of the buttons, apart from the start button and the pause button, of course, then it will show the program name and the time left. Like it would whenever you start the wash, and while selecting it. But yeah. I do wish that you could select some of the options together. That would be a game changer. Or have like extra rinse here instead of having silent mode there. I do find it a bit weird that it has silent mode and also night and day on it. But they're both different, so they are, so. Oh, they were already on video. Oh, that was funny.
Thank you.
rice in. You're still steaming it. Picking it up a wee bit, so it is. Does as long as that. Thank you. single microfiber cloth that was washed in WTG for 3 hours. And get these in the dryer. Bastard to the drum. I'm videoing. Dryer sheets all done. It's nice for me. So we'll do cottons extra dry. So yeah, hopefully being a nice day with Hoover today. Yeah, I think that tomorrow will be like part 5. Might do this as a 7-day thing then. So I think I might do that and then end it after that. So we still have cushion covers and 2 pillows to wash. So we'll do, and maybe curtains. I'm gonna emphasize the maybe though. But yeah. Thank you all so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and goodbye.